Hello students, today we are going to start a new topic in digital image processing, and that is color image processing. So up till now, whatever we have taken the image, how we represented the image and how whatever techniques we applied on the digital image, we were assuming the image as a grayscale image. A grayscale image is otherwise called as a monochromatic image. So in a monochromatic image or a grayscale image, the intensity small f, the intensity function small f, is a function of spatial coordinates x and y. So the intensity has only one channel and it produces a grayscale image. So in this chapter, in color image processing, we'll see that we can introduce additional channels of intensity to give a representation to color sensation of human perception. You can definitely identify which one is a grayscale image and what is a color image. There is no need to tell you that how a color image is perceived by a human being and how a grayscale image or a monochromatic image is perceived by a human being. You can definitely identify a monochromatic image from a chromatic image. So you should know that monochromatic image is a grayscale image, and a chromatic image, we say it is a color image, is more technically called as a chromatic image. There are two reasons why we are so much motivated to do color image processing. One factor is that color is a very powerful descriptor which can help human beings to identify and extract an object from a scene. Secondly, human beings can perceive a far more higher number of color shades than grayscale shades. That means if you want to compare, you can say that you can hardly discriminate between 12, 14 or 15 kind of grayscale shades, whereas when you are telling about your perception about color shades, you can discriminate between thousands of color shades. That is the characteristic of a human perception. Your eyes and your eyes well coordinated with your brain can clearly discriminate between thousands of color shades. Color image processing is broadly categorized into two areas. The first is full color image processing and the second is pseudo color image processing. In the full color image processing, the images are acquired using a full color sensor, like the ones used in a color TV camera or a color scanner. So in these kind of full color image acquisition systems, the sensors themselves can register the color information inherent in the scene. Whereas when we go to the pseudo color image processing, here the image acquisition system registers the information about the scene as a grayscale image. So you can say that the sensors here are not sensitive or not perceptive to the color information in the scene. So once the grayscale image is acquired, then what the pseudo color image processing do, it assigns a color to a certain range of intensities. Let's say we have a intensity range from 0 to 255. 255. That is the grayscale intensity. Let's say it varies from 0 to 255. So when we are in the domain of pseudo color image processing, what it does? It assigns color to the grayscale intensities. Let's say the system assigns a particular color to the grayscale intensities from 0 to 15. Then some different color is assigned to grayscale intensities from 16 to 80, let's say. Then from the grayscale intensity is 81 to 125. Let's say it is assigned to some other color. So likewise, different colors are assigned to different grayscale intensities actually recorded by a pseudo color image acquisition system. So once the color image is acquired, whether it may be by a full color image acquisition system or by a pseudo color image processing system, pseudo color image acquisition system. Once the color image is acquired, then whatever techniques we apply to the color image to enhance the image, to compress the image, to segment the image, and many other applications can be done to that color image which we have now. As you know that the white light is a continuous spectrum of colors ranging from violet at one end to the red at the other end. The human beings are perceptive only to a very narrow band of the entire spectrum. If you see, this is the entire electromagnetic spectrum, but the visual spectrum is only a narrow band of the entire spectrum. This is the visible spectrum. The entire electromagnetic spectrum can be characterized either in terms of wavelength or otherwise in terms of frequency. So once you know the wavelength, you also know the frequency. If you know the frequency, you also know the wavelength. So any one of this, either wavelength or frequency, can be chosen for characterizing the electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, coming to the point, the visible spectrum, let's say we are characterizing it in terms of wavelength here. So when you look into this visible spectrum lies from 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer, and it is such a small subset of the entire electromagnetic spectrum. A particular object looks to us of a particular color just because they reflect energies in a particular range of wavelengths. Let's say onto an object, a white light is incident to it. But out of all the colors which is comprising the white light, it is predominantly reflecting only reflecting wavelengths, energy in the wavelength 500 nanometer to 570 nanometer. Then definitely that such an object will appear to us mostly green. In another case, let's say some other object reflects all the colors incident to it. We are incidenting the object with a white light. Now we are talking that it reflects all the colors in a very balanced manner to the observer. In such a case, such an object will appear to us as of white color. Why? Because it is reflecting all the colors of the white. The white is comprised of the different colors, and that particular object is reflecting all the colors in a balanced manner. So in such a case, it will appear to us as white only. If one wants to understand the science of color, it is very crucial to characterize the light. If the light is achromatic, it is same as monochromatic. And what is monochromatic or achromatic? It is such a light which is void of color. So such a light, the achromatic light, is characterized by a single attribute, and that is intensity, the amount of light. So the intensity attribute is enough to characterize the achromatic light. So in such a case, the intensity attribute varies from the minimum to the maximum. The minimum intensity is termed as black, the maximum intensity is termed as white, and the gray shades follows from the complete black to the complete white in a white in a achromatic intensity range. Then again, when we try to characterize the chromatic light, we must know that the chromatic light spans from wavelength 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer. Three basic quantities can be used to characterize the chromatic light or the color light. Those quantities are namely radiance, luminance, and brightness. First, what is radiance? Radiance, it is the total amount of energy coming out or flowing out of the light source. It is quantified in terms of watts. So watts is the unit used to measure the radiance quantity. Now what is luminance? Luminance is a measure of the amount of energy perceived by an observer from the light source, and its unit is lumens. It's a very much observer dependent quantity. To exemplify this, let us suppose that there is a light source which is operating in far infrared region, and we have a human observer at certain point in the space. We already know that a human is perceptive only to the visible range of spectrum, not to the entire electromagnetic spectrum. And this far infrared region is beyond the visible spectrum. So, this human observer can least perceive the energy from that light source. So, in that case, the luminance for the observer will be almost zero for this light source and for his location in the space. And what is the region? Region being that the human being, the sensory visual system of a human being is least perceptive to the infrared energy. And this is the reason why the luminance will be almost zero for the light source. Now coming to the last quantity, the brightness. Brightness is a subjective measure, and it is quite similar to the achromatic notion of the attribute intensity. Brightness is more when the observer is close to the light source, and the brightness is less when the observer is far away from the light source.